In this session, I'm going to talk about your financial reporting. Business Central comes with out-of-the-box reporting that's called account schedules. You could also build your own customized account schedules. Account schedules, in my eyes, are like the internal report writer. The caveat is it only reports off of your GL accounts along with dimensions. So it does not look at subledger type reporting. It's strictly just your GL reports as well as your budget reports. So you can do an actual budget comparison within your account schedules. But what does come right out of the box is, let me go into a setup, into the general ledger setup. And this is typically preset, where you have a balance sheet, income statement, a cash flow, and a retained earnings report. So these four reports are kind of preset already for you to use and print out of the system based off of your specific chart of accounts, if you were to choose and change your own GL accounts. But for that to happen, if I go back into the chart of accounts, and we talked about chart of accounts in prior session, you need to update the category of each GL account along with the subcategory of each GL account. So based on the category and subcategory that you update on your GL account cards will dictate and transfer over to your financial reporting. So these are the two fields that are critical for you to get financial reporting using those preset reports that I just pointed out to you. Okay, so without these being populated, you would have to create your own account schedules, which is not difficult to do, but yet you still have to do it on your own. Or if you just populate the category and subcategory, this will automatically allow you to run your account schedules, your financial statements. So let's take a look at something else. So let's go to your GL account categories. Okay, so let me just back out just so you see I was in the finance, and within the finance menu, you had the chart of accounts and now GL account categories. This is what gets populated based off your category. See, GL accounts and categories. So by populating that category and subcategory, these numbers, these are GL account numbers, automatically get populated based on the flow of your categories. So this gets automatically populated. You see it's already an online, almost like a financial statement, basically. Okay. So now that this is populated based on your updating of GL accounts category and subcategories, one thing we want to do is to ensure that this flows and gets updated to your account schedules. Excuse me. So by doing that, I hit on edit list. I'm going to go to process and generate account schedules. And what that will do is that will update the existing account schedules that are in there with your related information. So if I click on generate account schedules, now everything is updated. You didn't see anything going on. It all just updated in the background, but those account schedules got updated based on your categories and subcategories, which transferred over to your account schedules. Now, if I don't want to use this information, which is, you know, just the online, because it's just your total information, right? There's no filter set. There's no, oh, I want to see from, you know, January 1 through January 31. This is your total balances to date. But if I want to do it and get an actual physical report out of it, there's a couple things you can do. You could either go to my general and go to account schedules and run it here. As you see, here's my standardized reports. Or I could go to, I'm going to back out. I'm going to go to my chart of accounts and I'm going to go to report account schedule. And this is where I could actually run the physical account schedules itself. And I'm going to choose which account schedule I want to run. So I'm going to choose the name. I'll just say I want my income statement. Click OK. And you specify by what dates do you want to run it as. 1-1 through 131, you want to see for the whole year, you have to specify the start date and end date. Any financial report you have to specify a starting and ending date. Okay, and then you actually could just print it. You could send it to different format, PDF, Word, or Excel, or you could even schedule it to run on a periodic basis. In this case, I'm just going to go back and I'm just going to preview it. Okay, all my settings. And this is what it would look like if you were to print it. This is my retained earnings account. Okay, nothing fancy, very black and white. It's not colorful, but yet it gets the job done. So let me change this out. Let me show you an income statement. Okay. Of course, there's not a lot of data in there, but you get the idea is that how it populates. It's going to update based on your account, GL accounts, categories, and subcategories where you could get out-of-the-box financial statements all preset. Now, if I wanted to create my own account schedules, I'm going to go back into your account schedules. And in here, I could actually go ahead and create a new one for myself. And this is how I quickly create one myself. So I'm going to, because I'm on an income statement, I'm going to go to Process, Edit Account Schedule. And it's going to ask you if I wanted to make a copy. And yes, I do, because I don't want to lose the existing one. I want to keep that as is. And I'm going to create, say, my income statement. Okay. It's only 10 characters long, so it's limited. But now I have mine. So what I did is I copied it, right? And now I go make my own changes if I wish to. Okay? Or I could start fresh. I could either copy it, which I did, because I didn't want to lose my old one. But realistically, I want to start fresh. Let's just pretend I start fresh and I get rid of all these lines. Instead of having to mainly bring in all of my individual GL accounts, which I certainly can, I could go to insert GL accounts, and this opens up my chart of accounts. And then from here, I could decide what accounts I want to bring in by simply clicking either one at a time, or I could, certainly say I want to start with my income statement and scroll all the way down to my net income, highlight them all, click it, and you'll see whatever's highlighted is what I'm going to bring in. Click OK, and now it brought in all those accounts. And then from here, I could either decide to merge the accounts together or leave them as is. And now I got my one piece of the accounts grid. I say one piece because it takes two pieces of to create one report. So basically what I just did is I created the lines for the account schedules, but what it does need is the combination of the column layout. So what do I mean by that? As you'll see, I have a name, which is my account schedule rows, and then I have a default column layout. And the columns are, if you visually think, if I just created my GL account lines, what are my columns? How do I want to present my columns? And my columns are used for maybe one column is actual, the second column is budget. Or one column is current month, next column is prior month, and so forth. You have a variety of ways of doing and creating, calculating columns based on your GL account rows. So in this case, for my account statement, I see my net change. So again, I'm going to go to Process, Edit Column. First it was Edit Account Schedule. Now it's Column Layouts. So if I go into here, I just have one column, which is net change. This is a kind of standard default and so forth, right? So here's my column header. If I wanted to do a maybe prior period, I could just type in what I type in the column header here is going to be, what you type is what's going to print out. Okay, so I could do prior period. And what I want to do for prior period is my comparison date formula. I'm going to go minus 1M. What that's telling us, I go back 1 month. Okay, so whatever my net, when I run my report, whatever period it may be, whether, for example, I do September 1 through September 30th, the second column is going to be minus 1 month, which would be August 1 through August 31st. So let's take a look. So if I say print, because I'm on, my cursor's on this statement. And let's just say I'm going to change this to 030120 and 033020. Preview. So you'll see two changes here. My net change is the period that I told it up here, 31 through 330. My prior period went back 1 month. Now, what if I wanted to say, you know what, that's great, but I want to see what the difference is because I got to calculate it. So I'm going to go back into my column layout. And because I have a calculation involved, I need to have a column number. So I'm going to say column one, number, column two, and this is going to be three. And I'm going to put in difference. And now I need to do a formula. So based on the formula, I'm going to tell it that it is a formula. It's not net change, it's a formula. And based on the formula, because this is formula, it's like, what am I calculating? Well, I'm going to calculate column two minus column one. So now I get the difference between the two. Okay, so I'm going to tell it column type is formula, and then what the formula is. And formula is two minus one gives me my difference. Okay, so let's take a look at it again. And now you see for the same report, I added a new column. So I got my current net change, which is the period up here that I specified, minus 1 month, and then give me the difference between the two. So that's a way of how you're going to build your own account schedules if you don't use standard out of the box. Thanks for watching. If we could further assist you, please reach out to us at epcgroup.net.